He just tells me now it's an open floor tent.
There's something outside. There's something rustling around.
Hey, hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing?
What is crankin'? Welcome back to the Goon Squad channel. Today, we are embarking out west in the far desert of Texas to do a little challenge, a little experiment. Glamping versus camping. We're about to meet the boys, that being Lojo and Rob, out in the middle of freaking nowhere. And we're gonna be unveiling his big $200,000 luxurious.
He's got something crazy. We've never seen it before. I think it's like $200 million truck.
Really, that's it?
$200,000 probably. I amped it up a little bit.
So while the boys are gonna be camping in their beautiful new rig, Brackley and I are gonna be sleeping on the-
Digging for dirt. We're gonna be in the dirt with the worms, with the snakes, with the scorps, all of that stuff. Stay tuned. By the way, if you want to look as good as we are, check out GoonSquad.com. Use code PITSTAIN and you can get this model right here that I'm wearing. Not really. But these are available new. Drawn's dripping. Look at y'all.
Sombreros. You've got the slime camo. Guggen slime camo. Long sleeves right now. Stay protected from the elements, from the sun. These are UV protected as well. And if you really want to protect your face like I need to because my nose is peeling, wear one of these amazing Guggen hats. It's all available right now. Check the link down below. Use your favorite content creator's codes. We're not gonna waste yet another moment. We're gonna hop in the truck and meet the boys, see what's going on. Adios. We've made it. The kingdom of possums. Get the full effect of the wind coming off the lake in this.
It's gonna be a little nipply, the north wind.
Yeah,
buddy.
Oh my gosh. Well, this is what we're going to be calling home for the next couple of days. I should probably take these sunglasses off because I look like an absolute tool. But yeah, we got no electricity, no propane, no water.
I did bring firewood.
We're going to get things set up right now, pop a tent up, maybe get our fire situation all handled because once nightfall comes upon this beautiful landscape of West Texas, it is going to get chilly. But for now, we're going to get busy and wait for the boys to come and pull up in their $200,000 luxury glamping rig. I don't know how Rack and I got picked to sleep outside, but it's going to be interesting.
Oh, it's got this big flag.
Oh, they got the flag up.
I remember that flag right here. Oh my God, is John already rigging?
They're rigging.
Are they going out tonight?
They need to be setting up their campsite here pretty soon, I think, right? Does the horn work?
Oh, I guess not.
It's a new vehicle, folks.
But I got lights. I can turn on all my lights for them.
Hey, guys!
Whoa!
Hi!
I gotta be honest, the pictures don't do it justice.
Yeah, this thing is way bigger than what you described.
Yeah.
It's huge.
That's what I said, too, when I showed up, and I was like, wow, that's way bigger than what I thought. Yeah.
Rolling hotel for the night,
it's
my friend.
Pretty big.
Welcome, I guess.
Yeah.
You'll wait until you see our getup.
Yeah. We're fabric camping.
He just tells me now. He's like, I got a tent. I'm like, cool. He just tells me now it's an open floor tent. He keeps saying we're sleeping on the dirt floor. I'm like, oh, that's a kind of a cool thing to say. Like, that's neat for the video. And then he's like, no, there's no bottom. It's just like it's a teepee.
It's a tarp.
Like we're going full Comanche right now.
This is ridiculous, man. Well, it's 20 feet up in the air.
It's insane.
This used to be an ambulance. So you can just imagine, but it's totally, totally converted. I'm excited to see what this thing can really do. I'm also very jealous.
This is the most Rob I've ever seen.
Dude, nice little rig you got here, buddy.
Oh, it's chilly. I don't like that.
Oh, it's very chilly.
I don't like that. Pretty much had this entire thing redone.
This thing is like a Humvee. Look at the bumper. Look at this bumper.
Dude, that thing could kill an elk.
Look at the winch. It's a 12,000 pounder. Dear God. It's a tank, basically, with a
this
hotel
is a tank.
Room.
This is a tank.
Dude, we should just sleep on top of this
tank.
That way I don't get a freaking rattlesnake that crawls in my crotch.
How sturdy is this ladder? Have you tested that yet?
Oh, yeah, you can go.
Dirty as.
Yeah, you should see up there. It's pretty neat, huh?
Whoa.
Yeah, I had decking
huge.
Put up there and there's a bunch of solar and everything, yeah.
Ah, it's a little dangerous.
Look at the view from up top. We got Rob Turkla's special deck. This is where he suntans nude. He doesn't really talk about it, but it does happen. I've seen it. This is where he lays, right there. Look at that view of old Possum Kingdom Lake. Beautiful sunset actually right now. The temperature is dropping, however, so we need to get our indoor living situation figured out, get some supper figured out, those types of things. He's even got his solar panels up here. What a guy.
Do a little
log action, bud?
Yeah, you know, I'm just checking out the old tanning deck. You getting ready to pitch tent?
I'm gonna pitch tent, make fire. You know, primitive life.
Very primitive.
Rob's Rambulance or Ambulance, whatever it is. I don't know how many people have died in it, but it sure is awesome. On these cold nights, it's gonna be so nice to have that. There's so much storage, beautiful kitchen and all that. Let me take you over to our kitchen and bedroom, all in one.
Sorry, we didn't tidy up before you guys got here. We probably need to, here, Rackley, you gotta do.
We have guests here. Okay?
I can't have people thinking that we're slobs.
Savages.
There we go, all right. Looks like.
I figured we'd maybe get a fire going because we got to cook tonight and then pitch our tent, which shouldn't take long because it has one pole and there's no floor.
Okay. It's a little fisherman's hack.
Holy moly. But hang on a second. No. What is this?
Don't worry about it.
This?
If you ask too many questions, then we're going to have to back out. Are you in?
Are your fingers setting this thing on fire?
Do you want the blue pill or the red pill? Red pill
is a safe pill.
This just in. Guggen Squad is hosting a tournament where you could win $30,000 in prizes. Here's how to enter. Head on over to one of your favorite places to pick up tackle, whether it be small mom-pa tackle stores, Academy, or Walmart. Go in, pick up a pack of Guggen baits. Upon checkout, save your receipt. Take a picture of that receipt and email it to entry@guggensquad.com. Grab some baits and submit your receipt, and you might have a chance to win $30,000 in prizes.
Blue pill or the red pill? Red pill
is a safe pill.
Okay.
Well, we're going to cook on this, so.
It's fine. You said you want a fast fire.
All right. This is acetone? Is that acetone?
I'm not sure. It's Spike It Dip and Glow.
Okay, I've never tried this. I don't know what this is.
You've never tried it.
I don't know. I just know it says flammable on the package. Fingers might get a little wild. That's all you need. Okay.
There she goes.
There she blows.
That's how you get a fast fire.
Woo.
Fun fact, your fishing lure die also works as ignition for your fire.
Now, how did you figure this out?
Did you get that on footage? So I thought maybe it was like kind of flammable. So I dumped a whole bottle on the fire and I lit it real close with my face right up against the tinder and just went, poof. It was like a little, tiny little bomb.
Just got Rob's boat unhooked from this awesome behemoth. So we're not having to drive around this lake for the next 4 days with the ambulance, but it's time to get things set up. We are getting our inside area here kind of cleaned out, ready to sleep, because it's about to be dark. It's about to be very cold as well. And the boys out there, looks like I'm seeing a tent getting pitched. I'm seeing a little bit of elevation in the middle, if you know what I mean. I also see a nice warm crackling fire. So I'm gonna help clean this thing out and I'm gonna get by that fire.
Here's our tent. We got some tent stakes. Got a pole, one pole. Here she blows.
This is wild. This is some OG Texas, West Texas camping right here. This
cowboy
is cowboy camping. Listen, I've done a good bit of camping. I've slept in freezing cold temps. Matter of fact, right before this trip, this Guggen week, I slept on the ice, a frozen lake. And you say that's nuts, but I'm like kind of raising an eyebrow right now. Okay, so this goes right in the middle, correct?
Yeah,
I'm just trying to figure this out. Okay, gotcha.
Oh yeah.
Starting to get a little pump now. This is kind of nice. I see. Then you take this and you widen it out.
Yes, sir. Now we're just gonna tighten it up a little bit.
Dude, and then in the morning we'll kill some buffalo and eat some cactus.
We should
lock them out of their van tonight, so they gotta camp with us.
It's like a clown car.
This is insane.
Wow. Okay.
I should have brought my tent, dude. I have like one of those like Coleman's where you just like literally it's a pop up. And
I thought Ryder was bringing his big white one. Don't you have the big canvas?
That takes up a lot of room, dude.
We're in a state park. We're in a state park right now where the whole thing's like 200 acres. Like, I don't know how much room you think this tent's gonna take up, but. Oh, dude, I'm definitely gonna roll over and hit this tent and just be like, oh.
I think it's good. Okay. Brian brought his backpacking tent out.
Dude, you're fine. Christ. You guys are gonna be fine.
Look at that. Look at how much room. I mean, you could get like lots right of room here, dude.
Dude, you sound like Step Brothers. Like, lots of room for activities.
Oh, shit.
It's already collapsing.
I hit it. I'm
What just happened?
I have ADHD and I like, what just there we go, happened? We're good. I hit the button, I'm like playing with it.
Oh, okay. We're all good. Yeah. All right, well.
So good. It was my fault, user error.
Yeah. No, it's great. It's good, guys. Let's get out of here.
Oh, we have to get out?
Oh, no.
Wow. Yeah. There's so much room in there. Oh, I wish I could sleep in there tonight.
You guys seen the bowling alley in there? Dude, there's a bowling alley in there, a full bar.
Dude, you can play
movie room.
In there.
Huh?
You can play Quidditch in there.
You can play Quidditch in there. That's how much room. Hey, man. Well, thanks for bringing the time. I'm not trying to be a Debbie Downer. It's just funny because this is a major contrast. When I heard that we were going to be doing a camping versus glamping challenge, I thought we were going to just throw in a tent. But this is legit. This is fully legit. One of us is going to end up waking up in the middle of the night and rolling over and knocking this thing down. I think it's going to be me. I'm a heavy sleeper, and I like to toss and turn, so.
Can you imagine?
I might come through this little slit right here and just end up outside the tent. Like, roll around.
Let's just hope nothing
gets in.
It's trying to, like, putting its nose in there.
There's something outside. There's something rustling around.
Shall I get the meat sire?
Got a Dutch oven here. Primitive cooking, guys. We're primitive cooking. Wonder what they're whipping up over there in the camper. The glamper, I should say.
We can't have Netflix and chill without Netflix, folks. And we have to get this figured out. Rob Turklett does not go to bed unless there is The Office playing in the background. It's a little known fact about him. So we gotta make that happen.
Oh yeah. We are hot, that's good. Yeah, we are very hot. In theory, we should wait for this to thaw and then cook it, but we are hungry primal animals at the moment. Oh my gosh.
Perfect.
I'm gonna pour a little more beer on top of that. Boom. Done. Well, you guys saw Rackley and I's get up. It is quite the situation. I'm actually looking forward to it. A little bit of bonding with my boy Rack. There's something so pure and blissful about walking out of your tent or wherever you're sleeping and seeing the view of a beautiful lake. Possum Kingdom is probably one of my favorite lakes ever, even aside from it being a great fishing lake. It's just so gorgeous. So now we're gonna go pan over to the boys, that being Lojo and Rob, and we're gonna take a look as to what it looks like to glam in a $200,000 vehicle.
I mean, there's probably not a lot going on here right now.
Don't you talk about the ambulance like that. Pop them lights on.
Yeah.
Let Rack Attack see the glory.
Come on, Rack, let's
see this.
That's just, I actually need to grab my...
There we go.
Sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, so
I'm getting little flashbacks from a month ago.
From our camper van? I am.
So it's I haven't really, done a lot. Like, this is supposed to be my storage for, my clothes and stuff that I use every day.
Uh-huh.
But it goes all the way back. And there's another one on the back side. I don't know, my God, you smell like smoke. You're strong.
I've been in
He's been
the
slaving
smoke, dude.
Over the
My eyes are like bleeding.
I've got propane.
All right, stove.
So you got a microwave.
Oh, shit.
Sorry there, sir.
Yeah.
There you go.
Look,
here's my toilet.
Yeah, I'm going to sleep
here. Oh, my gosh, dude.
Pretty cool, huh? Waterless, or water tankless, I think it's called.
Let's take a bag of popcorn.
Yeah.
Put that up again.
It's pretty cool.
On there. Have you used this yet?
No, I just watched a video on it.
All right,
so you take in there, and then you push this button, and it goes.
All right, we have to get this on video. Whenever you have
take
to
a poo.
Okay. Yeah, this hat. I don't. I have no idea. This is new to me.
Yeah.
It's like a. It ziplocks. It's like a.
It like spins and sucks and pulls down and.
There's gonna be a demonstration at 7:30 a.m. tomorrow morning.
I got Starlink.
So we get. Oh.
Yeah, I got Starlink in here. It's just kind of hanging out right now. This is literally the first time I've ever driven this thing and used it. I got a diesel heater in here, so I'll kick that on, and it goes on a timer, so it's tapped into my tank, so it pulls.
There we go.
It's going to be warm.
We'll give you that Wi-Fi password a little bit later there, buddy. Yeah.
Okay.
And then I've got roughly three to four days worth of battery. I can just keep everything on. So yeah, I'm at 96% right
this
now too.
Nice. This is probably one of the nicest interiors that I've ever seen inside of a custom camper.
Oh, that's not the password. Come on in, buddy. The water's fine. You can't stand up all the way, so watch your head.
Get some electricity here.
Dude! This is so nice.
I might just stay here. I might in the middle of the night scurry out of my little tent and just in that little corner right there, just I'm gonna roly poly it. I'm just gonna little.
This is so. Oh my god.
You guys have lemonade, soap.
They have soap. You guys have lemonade.
They have soap in here.
The only thing that sucks is you have to bend down a little bit to stand up.
What? Have you seen our tent? I gotta go like this to get out of the tent.
Let me get a closer look
here. Look at this, dude.
That actually, grab that piece right there. That piece is edible right now. That's ready to eat.
And that was on the top, probably the most frozen.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Dude, I'll eat that right now. Can I see it?
Give him a little of that.
Tell me how that salmonella is working. I think we're fine.
It smells pretty
good.
It's
been steaming for an hour. Steamed chicken is not bad.
Dude.
Is that incredible? It looks
good. Not bad. It's so moist, it's so tender.
Yeah.
Like, I mean,
can you taste a little Modelo?
I can taste the beer. Yeah. I can't taste the beer. Yeah. It's delicious, honestly.
Nice.
I think we've done good things here. So we got pork tenderloin. We got the chicken.
Yep.
We need to warm. John, we got to get you warm.
I'm trying.
We're going to go in a tent.
This man is cold.
I might sleep in bibs tonight, dude. Oh, man.
Oh, this is the difference right here.
Yeah.
I say we get the food off. We crank this fire up to 10.
Yes. Yeah. See? Now you're thinking.
Have a couple cold brews, we'll be fine.
Yeah. She's roaring.
That's going to be a huge fire.
We need a huge fire. You guys need a huge fire.
Give this more O2. All right, here's the food. Ready, boys?
Ready to reveal? Pork tendies.
All right.
And that lid's probably very hot, but...
Beer battered chicken.
Beer chicken with rice. Grab a plate, grab a fork, get warm, because it's going to be a long night.
I'm not going to move anywhere.
Actually, I think it's going to be a great night.
To be truthful, I might actually go watch a movie in there and kick the diesel heater on.
Hey, why don't we get our food, put on Netflix, fire the heater up, and just see where the night takes us, Rob.
You know what's funny about this?
Can we join you guys?
Please, sir. Can we have a blanket?
Please, sir. Spare a shilling and a piece of meat.
You know the best part about this? The last two Googan weeks, John has got absolutely screwed. Once, because the guy holding the camera gave us the worst rig in the world and stuck us a negative 20 degrees. And now he's sitting down here. It's going to be 31 tonight, and I bet you he only has sweatpants.
Oh. I only have sweatpants.
John, I've cooked some charcoal meats.
There's some rations, Rackley. Sire Rackley.
Would you like to
grab a hook of that meat?
Just grab it, dude.
Just grab it. Just take a bite of it. Just do it. Just do it. Just do it. Just do it.
The Black Plague has been so severe this season. I don't know if I can.
Warm yourself.
Oh,
serve your energy.
Oh man, that's really good, dude. I'm not gonna lie.
Can you imagine the kings in the castle sleeping tonight? They're probably having their maidens, their chambermaidens, come and empty their pots.
Look at his eyes. They're so,
crying, dude. This is probably the funniest thing I've ever heard from John. How is it?
It's pretty freaking good, dude.
Just a meat log?
Yeah, it's delicious.
It's a meat log.
All right.
This is it. We bid farewell to all of you guys. We're about to embrace upon...
No, you're about to embrace. I'm going to go have Netflix and chill with myself.
I say we as in Rackley and I. Yeah. Lojo and Rob are about to indulge themselves. Rackley and I are about to embrace for the winter elements. It's a shame because it felt so good there for a bit, and then all of a sudden it got really cold. And I'm so glad we put the tent as far as possible from the fire.
Dude, we can't sleep in the fire.
I would honestly lay across those coals if I could.
I've never seen you this cold. I've been ice fishing with you, and I haven't seen you this cold.
I'm chilly, man. I think I'm just so sick of it.
We have room. You can sleep on the floor.
No, it's fine. It's fine. We got it. We'll be all right. Hey, listen. No alarms needed. Just wait to hear for the splashing of me dunking my head, baptizing myself in the PK.
Yeah, cold plunge.
Yeah, PK cold plunge.
You guys stay tuned for the survival of glamping versus camping.
I've already got my little bed set up.
Wow, it is really cold in here. Like, stepping away from the fire, it is tremendously cold in here.
Oh, no. So, we both have these 4-inch pads that we're going to sleep on. I've got a sleeping bag inside of here, and I do have a fleece blanket in case things get really western.
Wow.
Just lace that baby up, get in here, we're gonna crawl in and sleep on the dirt.
Oh, nice. It's so crazy. It's like a couple days ago, I was just on like a Northwoods like camping trip on the lake. And for whatever reason, I'm like so tentative to be doing. I don't know what it is. It's just a different kind of cold. It's like in Texas, it's like a wet cold. And it's just like, it's in the air. It's like, it's different. But look at my breath.
Dude, there's moisture inside of here already.
Yeah. Okay.
I am legitimately cold since I got here earlier. It's kind of exciting stuff we got going on here, huh? Yeah. Let's turn to 75 for 16 minutes. Think that's all we'll need? She gets a cooking. Oh, TV's on. This is great. This is great. I'm gonna connect Starlink real quick. What are the chances John ends up in here?
I mean, I'm looking at that bed, that queen size bed up there, and I mean, I might find myself in there with you.
You're too big.
I'm just saying, man, it looks good over there. All right, well, I've got my canvas bag out with no blankets.
I got a
no pillow.
I got a pillow, Rod.
Rob's making stuff for me under his bed, like I'm a.
You don't like it?
I thought I would, but this is a little tight. I might have to do what you said. I just put the old footsies down there. Yeah, this is it. This is glamping at its finest, folks. This is luxury right here. It's gonna be so warm in this camper in about 15 minutes. The fact that I don't have a blanket's not even gonna matter.
Yeah, I'm out. See you guys. I'll see you guys in the morning. I'm gonna go ahead and just get the. Yeah, I want you guys to get out of here.
Yeah, get out of here.
Yeah, get out of my hair. I'm gonna watch some Netflix.
Yeah, get out of here.
This is so depressing. The fact that they're about to turn on like The Office right now. Yeah. Like the fact they're gonna watch The Office.
We're gonna maybe listen to it, like maybe hear some
from a distance. We're gonna be like half chuckling, haha, that was funny.
That was funny, remember that?
We bid farewell to you guys. We're going to hit the hay and why don't you get on out of here? We got some sleep and some beers to drink, okay? See you in the morning. Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you? Oh, it's a skunk. I think so. Oh, it's a skunk. It's a skunk. It's a big skunk. Oh, boy. It's a big skunk.
It's a joy.
No way. There's no way. Thing. Look at this.
It looks like a fat cat, dude.
He came to that food so quick. Hey, get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. Hey, get out of here.
Are we within spraying distance?
No, I'll get in front of him. Hang on. I'll get in front of him. Get out of here. Hey, get out of here.
Get.
You got no business here, sir.
Oh, gosh. He's coming at me, dude.
No, he's not. He's fine. He's not going to. He's his tail. It's a little one. It's a baby.
What?
It's a baby.
It looks like a full grown.
No, it's a baby. Hey, get out of here. I got plenty of experience with skunks. Get out of here. Hey, get out of here. Get out of here.
What kind of experience do you have?
I got it. It's all good. I'm not getting sprayed. I'm not getting sprayed. No, it's all good. Get out of here. Hey.
Oh, dude, he's got tail up.
Now it's bad. Now it's bad news. Hey, get out of here. What are you doing?
Looking for a grease.
Look at, that's a sick shot. Get out of here. Hey. Hey.
Hey, bud.
Oh, no. We're in the strike zone. Get out of here. Hey, no chicharrones for you.
Dude, he got it into our food, man. He got into our chicharrones.
You heard him. He was getting our chicharrones.
You seen the beer cans? We heard rustling and I was like, Lojo?
He's gonna come
Rob?
Back. He's probably gonna come back.
Is that the mystery animal or is that just animal number one?
It's animal number one. We're gonna have way more animals than that.
God, that was quick. We just crawled into bed.
We haven't fallen asleep yet. No. We're still awake.
Wow, dude, you got really close, man. I felt like you were in the strike zone.
Yeah, I've been there, done that. Been there, done that with skunks. They get all up my property up north. They are a piece of work.
I think it's going to be a long night.
For us, because we can hear everything.
We can just
I can hear them laughing at us. Oh, man. Oh.
Hey, don't worry. We got rid of the skunks for you guys.
We're going to bed for the second time now. Hopefully, no more disturbances. See if any more creatures come out tonight. See you guys in the morning, hopefully.
Well, I must admit,
I slept pretty good. First of all,
how was your slumber?
Look at the dew.
Dude, I think it's more than dew.
Why is
it
all on my side?
I don't know. I'm fine. I got a little bit of dew over here.
Honestly, me and John were pretty toasty last night in these bags. Let's go out and see the world. See what the world's got going on.
Arise to the sun.
We have risen.
The earth meets the eye.
I gotta put it
sounded like Transformers.
I gotta put an extra pair of socks. Well, yeah, we had a pretty good night's sleep. I don't know how the other boys fared, but if they got their heat working last night, then I imagine they probably got a good slumber.
Wow, it is chilly this morning. And although we have a diesel heater in this beautiful ambulance right here, Rob and I forgot to leave it on throughout the night. So it was basically on for like 25 minutes when we were getting settled in, and it was frigid in there the rest of the night. So we are still learning this vehicle. Tonight we'll do a little bit better. Maybe just set it on like a slow heat setting, like an all night thing. There's no way we were as cold as those guys, though.
That is ice. So that's probably the coldest night of sleeping I've ever had without a heater.
And we rocked it.
And we rocked it. It's pretty good. Hey, put it there. I doubted the system, but it really wasn't that bad. No BS. Whew. Oh, wow. And look at this, too. Oh, my gosh. Dude, I just woke up to a freaking postcard.
Good morning.
This is beautiful. Good morning.
How are we?
How are you
man,
doing?
Man, there is some frost on the old tent there, boys.
Yeah. No.
Oh, there's no literal snow on your tent. Yeah. Oh, my
there's rain
God.
Inside of there. It's a nice atmosphere.
So you guys created your own environment in there.
We did.
Just two men just created it.
Two men making heat.
If it makes you feel any better, we actually were pretty cold in there too because we didn't really set the heater. Like, we didn't set it for like an all-night setting. It was just on for like 20 minutes.
Oh, no.
So it got nice and toasty and you're feeling all good. And you wake up at 2 a.m. and it's...
Did you figure it out eventually?
No, we never turned it back on until this morning.
Wow.
Because I didn't know how to work it and he was asleep. So I was like... Just sitting there freezing.
That's why you can't rely on. That's why you can't rely on technology, man. You can't rely on these newfound gadgets. I mean, you got to go with the
brown water and campfire.
Yeah, brown water,
warm
campfire.
Warm yourself,
and just straight ingenuity
and a mustache.
And a mustache.
You guys getting find cold brown mustache?
No, we didn't. We were,
I was about
we were
to
just
say.
Kidding.
We were digging around last night trying to look for a brown water well, but didn't hit gold.
Didn't hit gold.
No.
I'm hungry though. I'm hungry.
Let's get some
is Rob
food.
Cooking
luckily
breakfast
for,
over there?
Luckily for you guys, Rob Turkle has got the skillet out. He is greasing that thing right now, and there's going to be some eggs and bacon on it.
We all stood.
No, here's the deal.
All right, guys. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir. Is that three? Thank you. We got to get fueled up because we're doing something really special today. It's going to be in another video. You guys need to stay tuned. And we're going hard. It's going to be a hardcore competition. It's for all the marbles and the special prize that we talked about last night. So I think we're going to just enjoy this beautiful breakfast with the sunrise and this foggy situation. And we survived. Survived last night in our tent. But we got many more nights to go. You guys need to stay tuned.
That concludes our glamp versus camp challenge. Hopefully you guys have a good perspective as to what it's like to be on both ends of the spectrum when you're out here in the wilderness. Both can be fun, but both, as you saw, have some drawbacks and some perks as well. Shout out to Rackley for setting up our camp today. I felt like
we won.
Yeah, I felt like we did win. I don't know if it was actually a challenge, but I feel like if it was a 2v2 against who had the most and the best sleep, the guys outside did all right.
We rocked it.
Yeah. Well, that concludes today's video, but it doesn't end this series. We're actually going to be out here for the next couple of days camping, fishing, cooking, having a couple brewskis, just enjoying the outdoors of Texas. Also, be sure to check out the new apparel, which is available now. Link down in the description below. Use your content creator's favorite code to save 10% off your entire order. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next episode of Camping vs. Glamping.
Oh, he's on too!
Listen up. The Googan Squad is hosting a massive online fishing tournament this April with $30,000 worth of cash and prizes. Here's how to enter. All you have to do is visit a local tackle shop or one of the big stores like Academy, Walmart, or Shields. You purchase literally any Googan product. Take a picture of your receipt and submit it to this email address right here. You got to get your entries in between now and the end of March. So guys, get after it. Right now, we're hosting this tournament just for you guys to give something back to the fishing community. I hope to see a bunch of you guys out there.